Joined now by CBS Sports Television host Adam Zucker. Adam, now that the tournament's back, I'm sure everybody over by you guys is just amped to have it return after everything that we went through last year, you guys went through, and of course the players. Hey, March Madness is back.
Yeah, I mean, look, there was so much we didn't know about the coronavirus a year ago, and I remember where I was standing in the supermarket when I got the update on my phone and the word that the tournament wasn't going to happen. And it was the same day that our public schools shut down in New Jersey as well, because we were already such a hot spot. So, you know, it's been a really long year for everybody. I feel really bad for the student athletes who couldn't participate in last year's tournament, who aren't around anymore. I mean, Obi Toppin's got a pretty good life now, but a lot of these guys didn't go on to the NBA. So I'm not only happy for the players who can participate in this year's tournament, I'm also grateful to them and their families and the coaching staffs, their support staffs, because, you know, it's one thing when you have paid professionals in a bubble. These are not paid professionals. We're asking a lot of these kids. And I think we've already seen it through the conference tournaments, just how much emotion can be created, the highs and the lows, because everyone's got something pent up in them from the last 365 days.
What is it about March that's particularly interesting to you? I mean, every sporting event has its own hook. You know, you got the Masters, you got the NFL, the playoffs, the Super Bowl. What about March Madness is particularly special?
Well, I compare the tournament to almost like the college football season, but crunched into one thing. And in college football, you know, you lose once, you might not have a shot at the national championship. It's watched by people on the edges of their seats and their couches because it's in their blood, because it's college sports. It's either where you went, where your parents went, where maybe the community you live in. There's always a connection as opposed to, you know, not many people went to Indianapolis Colts University. You know, there's a blood connection to a lot of these teams, or it's just the closest thing someone's area has to a pro team. And as opposed to professional series where it's the best of five, best of seven, or sometimes best of three even, all it takes is that one shot. So George Mason is not so possible elsewhere. Loyola Chicago, Butler, BCU, those just aren't as possible in any other realm. And that's what you get here. And because you have, you know, you have the good old bracket right here, it's something that everyone can kind of unite around. And it's a little, you know, you got to write down which TV station's going to have it this time and all that. But it's something that people fill out. My own kids can do it. And it just brings us all together, and not much does anymore.
Well, I'm sure 68 teams are on your mind right now. But here in Indiana, even with the whole tournament here, just one in-state team going to be participating. That's Purdue. What can you tell me that you know about Purdue? Obviously, they're a young team, have some great freshman talent, but what can you tell me about the Boilermakers?
Well, I think that they are such a great defensive team, and I love that the way that they played down the stretch is what's encouraging me. And Travion Williams down low had some monster buckets in some of those big games. Now, they appeared to be overmatched from a talent perspective against the behemoths of the Big Ten. That doesn't mean that they can't do a lot of damage in the tournament. But don't forget Matt Harms. Matt Harms is coming back home, and he's got restaurant recommendations.
That is CBS Sports host Adam Zucker. Adam, appreciate the time, and good luck to you and everybody over there at CBS Sports over the next month.
All right, cool, man. Thanks a lot.